This video is on sensory areas in the upper extremity relative to nerve roots and sensory areas in the upper extremity relative to peripheral nerves. When we talk about nerve roots or radicals, I'll abbreviate this as NR for nerve root, the sensory areas are known as dermatomes. I'm gonna write this out for you. Dermatomes. So these go with things like C5, 6, 7, etc. And of course, there are dermatomes for C4, C3, and C2. Technically, there really isn't one for C1. So these are areas of the upper extremity that represent primary areas of dermatomes or nerve root or sensory areas of innervation. So we're going to use some of the classic models. Hoppenfeld uses these clinically. These are pretty well accepted for the dermatome areas. So in order to do that, I'm going to draw an arm for you. And I've got a thumb, index, third, fourth, and fifth. And then we come here to the elbow and up. It's important to remember, and this is a palm up picture here, so that the thumb side is considered the lateral side of the arm. The pinky side is considered the medial part of the arm. Now, when we talk about basic dermatomes, I'm going to divide these up and then we'll color them in. We've got the lateral upper arm and the medial upper arm. We've got the lateral forearm, and we've got the medial forearm, and then we have the area of the palm along the third digit on the palmar surface. And the divisions work like this. This whole area on the lateral upper arm, and I'm shading this in blue, goes with C5 dermatome. The C6 dermatome is the lateral forearm, and I'm shading this in yellow, to the thumb and the index finger. So this would be C6. C7 is the palmar surface of the hand into the third digit. C8 is the medial forearm, into the fourth and fifth digits, and very important in testing, make sure that you do the finger component as well as the arm component. So this is C8, and then T1 is the medial upper arm. Right over here. So when we say there's sensory loss in any of these given areas, discrete areas, we're thinking specific dermatomes. In real life, the sensory areas have a lot of overlap, and that's why you want to stay away from the connecting areas between the two, where you can see the white line. I'll just bring that up in white a little bit more so you can see it. These are the areas to avoid where you see the white line when you're testing. So for example, if I want to test C5, I would go way lateral on the shoulder for C5 and way medial on the forearm for T1. For C6, I'd stay way lateral on the forearm over here, and I'd stay way medial for C8, and C7 kind of speaks for itself. So those are where the dermatomes are. We have pure patches, and these pure patches go along with peripheral nerves. And I'm just gonna abbreviate here. Pure patches go with peripheral nerves, and I always remember that as the two P's in pure patch go with P for peripheral nerve. And I'll abbreviate this as well, so peripheral nerve. And so these are areas, again, that are thought to be somewhat associated with specific peripheral nerves. By peripheral nerves, we need things like the median nerve, the ulnar nerve, etc., the named nerves. And we've got the axillary nerve, and I'll do these all in white so they stand out. Actually, let me take a color like this pink. I think that'll work. The axillary nerve pure patch overlies C5 dermatome on the lateral forearm. That's axillary. I'll abbreviate that for AX. The musculocutaneous nerve pure patch lies right over the brachioradialis muscle belly, and that's, I'll write just musculo, M-U-S, for musculocutaneous nerve. The median nerve sits at the lateral index finger, the distal part, for median nerve. The ulnar nerve sits in the medial part of the pinky. This is the ulnar nerve. And we have one more, and that's actually on the other side of the hand. And what if I draw that for a moment, this is now the back of the hand. So the back of the hand here, you can see a little nail bed there, and one here, and one here. And the pure patch that we have in the back of the hand is the radial nerve right there. That's the radial nerve. And you can see that even though this is on the back of the hand, and I'm going to go to this yellow, so we're using the same color. We've got the C6 dermatome that overlies and repeats areas of the radial nerve pure patch. So as you can see here, what we're really looking for in a clinical complaint is someone saying that they have numbness or tingling or pain in a certain area. It's not necessarily diagnostic, but it does tell us these are the nerve roots and specific peripheral nerves to investigate.